Let's talk about how to draw isomers from molecular formula very fast. Okay, so one of the big things that we run into in organic chemistry is that we're fighting the clock as much as we're fighting the material on exam day. And so if we can save a little time by using a strategy or a trick or a plan for a particular type of problem, we can get a few minutes extra to look back over our work on the rest of the test. So one of the things we can do is when we're trying to draw isomers from a molecular formula is the first thing we can do is calculate the degrees of unsaturation. And so a degree of unsaturation is either a double bond or a ring. And if we calculate two or more, that means it's some combination of double bonds and rings, or if it's two, it could be one triple bond that's present. So the degrees of unsaturation just refer to the absence of a couple of hydrogens in your molecule, indicating multiple bonds and closures of rings. And so we can write a formula which calculates the degrees of unsaturation that arises from Dalton's theory of multiple proportions, in that we know elements combine in simple whole number ratios, and the fact that the valences of the Lewis dot structures, things that bond four times like carbon, we take the number one and we add the number of carbons, things that bond four times. We add half of the things that bond three times like nitrogen. Oxygen actually cancels out of the progression, and then we actually subtract away things that bond once, so things that bond twice like oxygen cancel out. Things that bond once like hydrogen and halogens, we sum those up and subtract away the half. So having the formula, one of the key things this does for us is it allows us to draw skeletal structures and not to count hydrogens when we do these. We know we're right if our skeletal structure has the correct number of degrees of unsaturation. So let's consider C3H6O. Degrees of unsaturation, 1 plus 3 carbons, oxygen falls out of the equation, doesn't count, minus 6 divided by 2 for the hydrogens. Okay, and so 4 minus 3 gives us 1 degree, so there's either one ring or one double bond in all of our structures. So we can start with the linear chain. We need an oxygen, so let's make an alcohol. Okay, isomer here. We'll learn about enols later, okay, but that's definitely a possibility. Or we could keep the double bond in the same place, move the OH over, okay. Another thing we could do, we could make, instead of a double bond to carbon, we can make a double bond to oxygen. And so three carbons would look like this. We'd have an aldehyde, or we could have a ketone, 1 degree of unsaturation. If we move the aldehyde to the far side, it would make the same compound. These would be the same, okay? So you have to check to see if you make a symmetrical compound when you do these. Okay, so I can't see another way to do a linear version, although we could put an oxygen in the middle, make an ether. Okay, so now we've got three carbons, an ether, and a double bond, and looks to me like we may be set at this point for the linear structure. So then we can provide rings, three carbon ring. There's our degree of unsaturation there, the ring. Or we can put the oxygen in the ring and make an ether. And additionally, we could also do a three-membered ring epoxide functional group with a carbon group coming off for our 1 degree of saturation with the ring.